Hi, I'm Evan Poville. I'm a senior occupational therapist here at the Center for Discovery.
And I'm Danielle Keene. I'm an occupational therapy assistant.
And I'm Lisa Wagner. I'm a senior speech-language pathologist here at the center.
And welcome to our talk on maximizing engagement and participation through assistive technology.
Today, we're going to be talking about the importance of promoting independence for individuals. We're going to show you many different ways that someone can participate in the activities based on their abilities.
In the following video clips, we'll share three familiar activities and a variety of ways to adapt these tasks for increased independence and engagement. Some of the adaptations you will see are commercially available. Some were developed by our innovation team here at the Center for Discovery.
One of the very useful commercially available devices you'll see is the switch latch timer. It's for any battery-operated devices. It's going to allow for a sustained activation of the device with a single press. So basically, for a lot of individuals, it's going to be difficult possibly for them to reach out and hold down the switch for the full amount of time that you need. This is going to allow you to either use the timer for seconds, or you can do it for minutes. And you set the timer, and one button press is going to activate the device for that long. Also, it has the latch on and off switch, which means that you just press it and it's like a light switch. It's either on, press it again, and it's off.
So we're going to show you how to use the switch latch timer and set it up. Here we have our switch latch timer, our adaptive scissors, and our switch. The first part is we're going to take the cord from the switch latch timer and attach it to the scissors. And then the cord from our switch will go into port one, switch one, on the back. You can adjust the time, and again, the time seconds, timed in minutes, or latch, which is your on or off. So you would activate the switch once, would turn it on. You'd activate the switch again, and it would turn it off. So I'm going to set it to about 7 seconds. It's in seconds. I pulled all the way up. And then when you activate the switch, it then will cut your paper.
In this next video clip, you're going to see the use of a commercially available Y-splitter cable, which is going to enable a single switch activation to enable two separate devices. In this next video, you're just going to see the setup of, again, the commercially available Y-splitter, and that's going to be connecting a switch latch timer for the pouring cup, which we will see in upcoming videos, and again, tied in with the TCFD-designed Bluetooth audio controller, enabling a single switch use to control both devices. What you're going to see here is an individual doing a vocational task of pouring soap from a pouring cup, and we're going to be using a commercially available switch latch timer, and that's going to allow you to time how long it's going to take for the pouring cup to go, and that's paired with a TCFD designed, a Bluetooth enabled audio player, which also includes a timer that we can synchronize with the switch latch timer to add a motivating audio component to what's otherwise a very quiet vocational task that can be motivating, but also really excellent for somebody that's visually impaired and may not be able to see what's going on, to have an added component to know that there is some cause effect to what they're doing. In this next video, you're going to see an individual who is enabling both the pouring cup to roll the dice and at the same time going to be playing music along with it to know that she is actually rolling those dice. In the next video clip, you're going to see a young woman who is painting using the commercially available music machine through enabling devices, paired with a switch latch timer and synchronized again with the Bluetooth music device, which also is synchronized to the same time as the switch latch timer.
All right, Christina, can you show us how it works?
Ready to paint? Hold on to the
A simple foam roll is used here to increase the size of a paintbrush, making it easier to hold for anyone with decreased strength or limited dexterity. When increased assistance is needed for painting, an adapted tool holder with strap can be helpful for sustaining the grasp and angling the brush to what you're painting. For someone that may not be able to hold or grasp a tool, switch access is another great way to paint and can be adapted in a variety of ways. Here, a music machine is used to create brush strokes. In this scene, a plastic folding board can be used to achieve a neat fold. These boards are helpful in learning the steps of folding. They provide stability, and the fold can be completed with one hand. Here, a folding board is used with switch access. A voice output device can be used to direct the action of the fold. In these next two videos, you will see a switch-adapted laundry folding board, which allows the folder to complete the task with a single press of a switch or by pressing the switch for each step of the fold.
In this video, we'll be showing a bunch of ways of rolling dice. Here is someone who is able to grasp either a cup or a jar to be able to flip over to pour out the dice. Another way is to get a large playground dice. They are soft foam. Place them on any surface and allow the individual to push them off. In this video, we're showing the alternate spinner attached to a switch. The individual will activate the switch, making it spin. Giving it time will allow it to stop and present a number.
This concludes our talk. Thank you for joining us, and we're now going to open the floor for questions.
Thank you so much. We do have some questions coming in. If you have any questions out there, please just go ahead and type them into the chat box. We have a couple minutes. We'll answer what we can. And then there will be the email if you have follow-up questions later. So one person, one of our audience members said they have been completely inspired by your presentation, and they're wondering what other tools could possibly be switch adapted.
Sure, so many tools and toys that are battery operated and have a simple on-off switch can be easily adapted with battery interrupters, which can be ordered in a pack, and then accessed with a capability switch. We also showed the option of if a switch is not able to be used for a task or there's no battery involved, we could use a voice output device to direct the action of the task.
Okay. Thank you very much. We have another question coming in. What are some activities that you would recommend using the Y splitter for, and who can benefit from the Y splitter?
Okay, so the Y splitter works great having some auditory feedback for any activity that does not give you a lot of auditory feedback on its own. So things like if you are doing a baking activity and pouring dry goods into a bowl with a adapted pouring cup, you would want some of that. The music would really help for the feedback. Also, anybody that may have a visual impairment that they're not able to really easily see what they're working on, as well as anybody that you would really want to more strongly push the cause-effect relationships with, those work really well for those individuals.
Great. Excellent.